Concept was for a gargoyle. I've always liked gargoyles, and just the fact that they're kind of protective of evil spirits, you know. But I think, you know, these days we don't have to worry about stuff like that. It's more about the environment, things like that. So I didn't want him to be a scary gargoyle. I wanted it more of a soft feel to it, more of a human touch. It's about a 2-week project, so I decided to have him crouching down and give him the flower, kind of staring at in puzzlement with it. So most of this is all scrap steel, pretty much all of it is. I just went to the junkyard and found a bunch of stuff, so it's all recycled too. That's the whole concept behind it, kind of like, what are we doing these days? And, you know, are we doing anything to take care of this, or are we just going to kind of keep moving forward?
I've been painting for about 65 years with an easel, vertical, and using a palette and painting with brushes. And I decided that I was tired of the marks I was making with brushes, and I was trying to come up with something new. So I took the canvas, put it horizontally, and liquefied the paints in jars, poured them on, and then they ran together and so forth. And I held the canvas like a pinball machine, letting them run together and fuse and so forth. And then I got my hands into it. Then I sprayed into it. Then I used paper, putting it down, making monoprints into it. And I kept coming up with all these new effects, shapes and forms, which I had never made before. It was getting away from the brush, even though there is some brushwork in the canvas.
I am basically a landscape painter, and I use acrylics most of the time. This was just sort of a little accident that happened with another painting that I had, where a little thread fell on it, and I thought, I don't like the way that looks. I like the gesture line and contour lines, and it just sort of inspired me to do this piece. And it sort of speaks to the kind of nervousness about nature right before from winter to spring. Everything just sort of seems like it's vibrating, and I think the threads kind of I don't know, they showed that to me. I just love the landscape tradition, but I also love drawing. And with the thread, I could draw on top of on top of the painting with line, and sort of just let it happen. I like the accidental things that happen. That it wasn't a deliberate stroke. That thread just sort of fell the way it wanted to fall.
Basically done with mixed media of different types of papers that I painted on, and gone back and cut up their screens and sticks, and everything is, even a basket material. There's pieces of fabric. It's just sort of like all the idea of just trying to get things to be happy. So that's basically what I was doing, was just going through some drawings and taking them, putting them back together, and trying to make a three-dimensional, I wanted to do a three-dimensional drawing. That's really what I was after.
The third place winner of tonight's exhibit is Carol Klingel.
Carol's piece is Next to the Pigs in Sunlight. It's not paint exactly, it's thread. It's all the way down the other end of the room.
The second place winner is Christy Wall. Is Christy here? There.
Christy's piece is on the pedestal and the center of the gallery on that wall. It's the paper and mixed media sculpture.
And the first place winner tonight is Joseph Walton.
And he's